Hey everyone, this is the LEGO DC Comics Super Heroes Wonder Woman Warrior Battle set to go with the upcoming cinematic live-action Wonder Woman movie. And this makes me happy because it comes with another giant figure. This is Ares, the god of war and major antagonist for Wonder Woman. I call this a giant figure because it's bigger than a big fig. It's actually fully built up from scratch, from regular pieces and such. And this is the second of this type of design of figure that we've gotten from LEGO. The first one was Giant Man, or Giant Ant-Man, from the Marvel Universe previously, and this one is built very similarly. And it's designed to look like a scaled-up LEGO minifigure, so this is supposed to represent basically Ares, if he was a minifigure, then built larger, kind of a Toy Story sort of style. So once again, it's using the relatively new short cylinder piece with a diameter of 4, and that's actually a printed piece right there, which is great to see. And he's got just minifig style legs, and he's got some different colors. There are actually some quite interesting different colors that are used throughout the build of the major parts of this set, but you know, you put him into a walking pose and then you can see how it's literally just a giant scaled up LEGO minifigure. Has similar articulation. You can turn the neck back and forth as the two legs can be moved independently. This also has the ability to move the arms out, which is good, which regular minifigs don't. And you have a little bit of extra articulation at the wrist because this can be moved back and turned in and out. Accidentally pulled that out, but there we go. You can also take the large sword, it's kind of a large action figure sword, out of the hand entirely. And the shoulder has a ball joint. Each shoulder has a small Mixel style ball joint in it, so that can be moved around quite a lot, and you get different kinds of poses with it. They use a nice large action figure piece here. Let me just quickly show you how that's attached with just a couple of jumpers there. Very simple. Unfortunately, figure does not look good from the back. You know, on the front, it's got nice detailing. I'll show you the head a little bit better, but it's got nice detailing via the stickers. But then on the back, it's just all black. And you see, again, more of the colors used in the interior of this. And I don't know about the tan right here. I'm okay with the dark tan here, but this one back here is kind of weird to me. I think it was trying to create a little extra visual interest. But yeah, could have been more interesting looking from the back. The head is really good, though. Again, does uses stickers up here for kind of the helmet that is an animal skull that's been partially taken apart. I think that the Ares character in universe looks really, really cool, bad in a good way. I feel like this kind of takes some of the badness away from that, and I think that's entirely intentional. It's LEGO doing their thing, minifigurizing very, very evil, bad characters to make them, you know, more approachable by kids. And I totally get it, and I love them for it. They could have made this more realistic, for sure, with better proportions, but they went for the minifig style, and I think it was a good decision. Last thing about the head is that the jaws are also on Mixel style ball joints, so those can kind of be moved around if you want to change the pose of those, kind of open up the face a little bit more or close it up so you get more of that, you know, closed jaw sort of look. And then the horns are able to move around, not just for accuracy, kind of getting the pose that you want, but also to give you some room if you're moving the arms around, because they'll tend to get in the way. So you can turn these out, you can bring them up and down as you wish. You could even bring them up like this if you want to have just a completely different look to it. You know, it almost looks like it's kind of getting into a scorpioid sort of thing, insectoid sort of thing, maybe. I'm not sure. Just something different that you can do. And then this is the other major build that I think is actually based off a real one. As best I can tell, it represents a series of German aircraft called Eindeckers, which just means single deck, referencing the fact that it's a monoplane, which was weird back then. Most of the warplanes of World War I, at least most of the ones that you tend to see in media, were biplanes. So this was strange that it was just a monoplane, a very small and light thing, but this looks very much like that craft. I might be wrong on the exact identity of it, but it sure looks close. Got the radial engine detail in the front, which is done with, again, just a sticker there, but that totally makes sense. You can spin up the propeller and see the cylinders behind it. They've got the two stud shooters up on the top. There are a couple of extra shots included in the set for that. You know, these are exactly where they should be on this type of aircraft. They don't use German markings on it because, of course, they're not going to use German markings on it. It just wouldn't go with the whole Lego thing. But I think that the markings they put here look pretty good. Again, just the overall look of the plane is good. The proportions are good. This is actually surprisingly close to proper minifig scale. I mean, the actual planes were roughly this size relative to a person. Back here, you have the ability to turn the rudder from side to side a little bit. You're not able to operate the horizontal control surfaces there. It's got a little tail wheel back here, and I think this is the first time that they've used the Fun at the Park wheelchair wheels on something other than the wheelchair, I believe. I might be mistaken on that, but I think it is. And that's great. I look forward to seeing these used many more times because they are very useful pieces, hence the reason that I got a bunch of them. I've actually used them already myself, and they look perfect here. This is just the right kind of use of them. This is nice and sturdy here. The whole thing is very swishable, very playable. Has a couple of rockets on the undersides. In World War I, they did use aircraft-launched rockets, so these are actually appropriate. They are just the old Flickfire missiles, which I think look pretty good. Don't work as well as the spring-loaded shooters, but these are more low-profile and look more appropriate, so I appreciate them not sticking big old, huge, thick, you know, modern shooter pieces on there, which would have kind of ruined the look, I think, on this small, lightweight craft. Also has a little console in there for the dude, and that is a printed piece. The dude is Steve Trevor there on the left, and of course on the right is Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman is the major figure that you want from this set. Of course, her figure looks very good. Great printing along the sides of the arms and also the legs. I'm especially impressed with the alignment of the printing going around the sides of the legs. Sometimes that's off on some figures, but this is really good. And I'm also very impressed by the printing on that shield. That also looks quite very nice. They put in some darker silver color. I think it's a dark pearl, metallic pearl gray or something like that. It's a gunmetal gray color, which is kind of subtle, and you can see when the light hits it just right, you can see the little bit of sheen from that. Let me actually move this shield out of the way completely so you can see the rest of the printing around this side as well. It's just mirrored around. Yeah, that's really good stuff. And they have some alternate stuff going on for both of these figures. Nice hair piece as well. That's in dark brown there. Have to take that off though to show you the alternate face. Wow, that is strong. That's a very strong facial expression. Goes really well with the headband. I appreciate that very much. The alternate one for Steve is also good. I think that it's appropriate for, you know, being under stress and an adrenaline rush and, you know, in the heat of battle. Just looks pretty good for that. There's a clearer look at the main faces without anything else on. And then they also give you this hairpiece, so Steve does not have to have that Anakin Skywalker Star Wars Episode I helmet. That's what it always reminds me of. And for Wonder Woman, they also include a cloak for her, which includes the cape piece and the hood. There's how that looks all outfitted up, and I think that looks good as well. It is the older style of cape piece that is slightly crinkly, but to me it feels a little bit softer than they have previously. This won't crinkle quite as much, quite as readily. It's not as crackly feeling and sounding even as you just, you know, use it. So I think that's a little bit of an improvement over the previous materials, but just the whole thing goes together well, and I really appreciate having the two alternatives for each figure. That is it for what is included in this set, though. I think that every single thing here is good. Love giant figures, glad to get another one of those. This plane is done really, really well. Surprisingly realistic and yet very playable. And the two minifigures are also done very well as well, in my opinion. So from me, really no complaints here, other than just the strange bits of strange color that show up in some places. Believe it or not, this plane is built with dark blue on the inside and also a really bright medium azure, but it's completely covered up. So they actually did a good job on this one. Overall, yeah, nice solid set. No real failures here and some surprises in just how good some of it is. Those are my thoughts though. Let me know your thoughts, share what you think about it with your honest opinion in a comment down below. I'll be talking to you again soon. Thanks for watching.